and so brought happily to the glory of the resurrection. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. As Jesus and his disciples were proceeding on their journey, someone said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." Jesus answered him, "Foxes have dens and birds of the sky have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to rest his head." And to another he said, "Follow me." But he replied, "Lord, let me go first and bury my father." But he answered him, "Let the dead bury their dead, but you go and proclaim the kingdom of God." Another said, "I will follow you, Lord, but first let me say farewell to my family at home." Jesus answered him, "No one who sets a hand to the plow and looks to what was left behind is fit for the kingdom of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Ayaw niya ng sipat ay hindi tutunan. Gumagawa lang yun ang paraan para maging sipat. So many doctors examine the wounds of Father Pio and they do not explain how the wounds were there. At dahil po, ano alam mo ang ginawa ng simbahan kay Father Pio? Pinagbawalan siya ng misa. Pinagbawalan siya na to hear confessions. Dahil na yung mga tao ay medyo nalilito na. So, as a priest, na ang buhay niya ay ang pamamahal niya lalo na sa Eucharistia ay makasakit mo para kay Padre Pio na magbawalan siya na mag-celebrate ng misa. But when the time came, the perfect time came, marami na naniniwala ko na hindi faith yung mga miracles ni Padre Pio until Pope John Paul II. Time na steep as what of our saints interceding for us. Amen. Gusto ko lang ulang i-highlight ko yung favorite sali ni Padre Pio. Ano yung favorite sali ni Padre Pio? Sabi niya, pray, hope, and don't worry. Napakaganda mo. Pray, hope, and don't worry. Sa ating alam natin, no? Before, sabi nga sa mga research daw, yung ating mga worries daw, most of them are or happened in the past. Ibig sabihin, nangyari na. And some of them also are still not happening, are still wasting the future. Kaya minsan, hindi na magulog yung ating mga worries. So I remember the story of two monks. Pauwi na sila and then lumakas ang ulan at ang baha. So, on their way, nakita nila may isang magandang babae na hindi magka-cross doon sa kabilang lugar. Kaya ang ginawa ng isang monk, kinarga niya yung magandang babae at itinawid doon sa kabilang para magka-pawin sila. So, in the evening, yung kanyang kasama mo, kung pinunahan yung monk, sabi niya, brother, di ba? It's not allowed for us to touch a woman. And then monk said, yes, I am. And then, natanong ko yung iba, isang kasama niya, but why did you carry the woman? Alam mo lang sa loob ng monk, sabi niya, I carry that woman and left her already in the road. But you are still carrying her until now. Yan ang worry. Nangyari na, pero yan na lang ang nangyari na eh. But that is exactly what happened to us. Kung titingnan natin yung mga pagbasa, so yung first reading, the book of Proverbs, kung tama yung binasa na nila yung book of Proverbs. Ano ang gusto ipaalam sa atin about worrying? Nakatulong ba ang pag-worry? According to the book of Proverbs, two things I ask of you. Deny them not to me before I cry. Put falsehood and lying far from me. Give me neither poverty nor riches. Provide me only with the food I need, lest fully I deny you. Say, who is the Lord? Or being in one, I say, I profane the name of my God. The word is, provide me only with the food I need. And I think we can relate also to that sa prayer ay ginawa ng ating Panginoon. Di ba, when we pray the Lord's Prayer, ano ang sabi? Give us this day our daily bread. because sometimes sabihin niya, those people who work, who keep many things because they wanted their future to be secured, are those people who worry a lot. In the gospel, talks about sending the apostles and telling them, take nothing from the journey, neither walking stick, nor sack, nor food, nor money, and let no one take a second trip. Whatever house you enter, stay there and leave from there. And for those who not welcome you, when you leave that town, shake it as from your feet and give testimony against them. We get a commandment not to take anything because the Lord said, He will provide for you. My dear brothers and sisters, today I know we have our own worries. Sometimes they worry about their children. And iba, they worry about their finances. And iba, they worry about their health. And there are things that we worry about. At alam natin kung ano ang sagot ng ating Panginoon sa atin. He assured us that look at the birds, look at the flowers. They don't work, but look how the Father takes good care of them. My dear brothers and sisters, I know our worries, or that is part of us, we worry. But I hope in our Eucharistic celebration today, we also come on our faith, on our trust in God. Believing in His words, when He said, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all these things, and all these worries, and all these things that we need will be upon you. I think that is one answer to our thinking of worrying too much. It is because of our being me-centered. What will happen to me, or what will people say about me? My dear brothers and sisters, today we ask God with you. We ask His inspiration to pray, to hope, and not to worry. Because we have a God who gave us, who provided us everything. We have a God who can work miracles. We have a God who can feed those who are hungry, who can heal those who are sick. We have a God who is always there for the lonely and for those who have problems. Let me end this with a short story. Minsan, may isang tao na nakaupo. So sabi ng isang tao, "What are you doing? Are you not studying?" "No, I'm not studying." "So why should I worry about studying? You need to study so that if you study well, you can have your work. And if you have your work, you can prepare a house for your family, for your children. And then after that, you can sit down and relax." And then I told him, "So why should I worry about those things? I am here already relaxing." But I know all these things, all these blessings will not be given to us if we do not see the love and mercy of God. As what Padre Pio also mentioned, that if we pray, we shake the heart of God so that His grace will fall among us. Amen. Let us all stand up. ministers to spread the good news of salvation to all. He has asked God to make us credible witnesses. In every petition in our responsibility, Lord, empower us to be your witnesses.
Lives and reigns
forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
your right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you look on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her the author of our salvation, your Son Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. Your voices we pray, join with us in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son
and filled with His Holy Spirit, we become one body, one spirit in Christ. May He make us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance of your elect, especially with your most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Patrick, with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for our prevailing God. May the sacrifice of our consolation be brave, O Lord, and bless the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your building the church on earth, with your servant Francis of Paul, John our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give them an entrance to your kingdom, there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through Him, with Him, and in Him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory now is yours, O Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Thank you.
This is our Lord Jesus Christ, who is telling us today not to worry. Let us give everything to God and trust His mercy. This is the love of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called His Son. Blessed be raised up the Lord, those who knew with his sacrament that he began to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord. Please be for our oratio iterata to end this time. We pray together. God our Father, we come to you in our name to ask your protection against the COVID-19. That has claimed lives and has affected many. We pray for your grace for the people tasked with studying the nature and cause of this virus and its disease, and of studying the time of its transmission. Guide the hands and minds of medical experts that may minister to the sick with confidence and compassion, and of those governments and private agencies that must find cure and solution to this pandemic. We pray for those afflicted, and may be restored to health soon. Grant us the grace to work for the good of all, and to help those in need. Grant this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Peace, Christ. So before we find the blessing, pastoral natin ang ating sponsor ngayon, ang pinig at guidance of His Spirit. So, maraming salamat for spending your time with us. And also, for grade 12, already opening French for this day today. So, our dear Divinians, good luck to you in the exam. May the Lord give you the gift of wisdom And in spite of the pandemic, you will learn many things. This coming Friday is our spiritual formation. At the Aming Teachers Month ngayon, the campus ministry office will prepare something for you. Magkaroon tayo ng kunting agape. Magpapansin kami dahil Teachers Day, Teachers Month. No? And personally, lahat naman tayo, all of us are teachers, no? Kaya yung mga support team, yung ating mga non-teaching staff, we are all teaching our children, no? In our actions, and especially our teachers, in their words also. So, we'll see each other. So, alas tres kami tayo na. No? So, we have our Bible sharing, and then we have our Holy Mass to thank the Lord for the gift of life, for our birthday celebrators from the month of September. Happy birthday to you, Sir Ag. So, kapag-alim ni Sir Ag. Palagpakan, anak mo. The Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
Yeah, may God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass has been offered as a go to love and serve the Lord and trust Him, not more. Thanks be to God. Let's sing our song.